everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and this is going to be a really short video, but we just wanted to show you. This is what's happening on December 15th. We are still having blossoms on this honeysuckle vine. Now, the other ones are not blossoming, but for whatever reason, this one has decided it will.
This has been a pretty strange winter.
It has.
I love it.
We've had about 4 days of winter and the rest has been spring. But we don't want it to last too long because it'll mess up all the timing for all the plants. But it's been interesting.
That it has.
It's almost got into the 60s yesterday, I think. We've had rain, we've had thunder showers. People that love snow and whose businesses rely on snow are not happy, but it's coming. A couple of years ago, when it was warm like this for so long, this quince bush here actually had flowers. And as we look at it today, it's starting to get green. I don't think these have
plus it's budding on this other stem.
It's starting to bud. Well, and then you hear about Washington, D.C., how the cherry blossoms are all out. That is not good. One last bush I wanted to check was the forsythia, because they are one of the first ones that bloom in the spring. And while it's not blooming, the buds are huge. Look at this.
Yeah.
I would say this is full. Yeah, if it stayed warm long enough, a couple weeks or so, I'm sure it would. I'm glad I don't see any tulips coming up. That would be very disheartening. Or daffodils, but so far so good, because we have all the leaf mulch on them. They're hidden away, so hopefully they're not being tricked.
Well, let me take you back to one other place and get your suggestions.
This is our main concern as far as trouble in the garden, I guess. This is a pear tree, a flowering pear tree, and we noticed once all the leaves fell out that the trunk itself is actually cracked and cracking more and more. And as we look at it, we're thinking it's because of this branch right here that's pushing this side of the tree away from this side of the tree. It's actually growing and breaking it in half. So if you have ideas, if you've ever come across this, we're thinking maybe eliminate this branch here and drill a big bolt between the two main parts here. So,
or I may straddle it, or, you know, with some, I don't know.
You can't girdle it.
No, like a rubber, you know, the gaskets they put on plumbing, but that's a pretty big piece of plumbing.
Yeah.
So I don't know. I've heard of people putting
like a steel rod.
Yeah, a threaded rod that has washers and bolts on both sides, mm-hmm. so that as you know, you get it to try to make contact, and then you know, as need be, maybe you loosen the bolts or you don't, and let the tree grow over the bolts. Right. It's such a beautifully shaped tree, though. Take it down.
So if you have any ideas, we truly appreciate any help you could have. Please give us a thumbs up. We want to thank you so much for watching. And if you have comments or questions, love to hear them. Love to hear what's going on in your
part of the world.
Part of the world, in your area. If you're having unusual weather, we'd love to hear about it. And as always, we'd like to have you subscribe and become part of our garden family.
Yeah, look at Denver with all the snow they've had, and the sea foam that is blowing up on people from the West Coast.
That's that El Nino thing going on.
The blossoms, the cherry blossoms in Washington, D.C. Yep. I mean, you know, this is an interesting winter.
Yep. But
Merry Christmas
to everybody, and Happy New Year.
Bye. Prosperous and healthy.
Yes.
Bye-bye. I'm may have to bring the lawnmower out.
Connect with us on YouTube.